Hello, this is for Monday, the 8th of November, 2021. And my name is Collins, and I've come to bother you again. And I'm so excited. I'm going to do laundry today. But also, I've got two new books coming out on the shelves. I have my new fiction, which is just recently finished, and the artwork for the cover is all done by Daphne Powers. This book is called Citizen Karen. Citizen Karen is a story of an unassuming 34-year-old divorced mother who works at a seafood restaurant on the shores of Lake Erie, who decides to assassinate a congressman, and also of her beloved 16-year-old daughter who sort of acts as her guiding light, her wise-ass guiding light. So these two characters are the main focus of the story. And it's a little bit provocative, I guess you could say. It's getting high marks from Ken Joseph, who likes to read my things before I publish them. So that's that. I'm going to publish that, like, today, I guess, out on Amazon. And then also back on the shelves at Amazon is my book from a few months ago called Blinkdown. Blinkdown is the story of an American black man who wakes up 2,000 years in the future in a world with no white people. And what happened was not that he can travel in time per se, but that they scanned him. They looked back in time at his molecules and built him up and recreated him, sort of, so that he wakes up in this world that he can't go back from, when he doesn't know anything, can't speak the languages, and he has to find his way forward. He's like, he's been kidnapped, just like his ancestors, and he has to find love and work, and one of the works that he finds is with these people who look back in time at lost manuscripts that are, you know, in the Library of Alexandria and places like that, knowledge that was thought forever lost, they can actually go back in time and look. Not they don't go back in time; they look back in time, and are able to scan objects of knowledge. And he becomes involved in that business as well. And then he gets to meet the Queen of the World later on. But I don't want to give away too much. But that's pretty. Pretty exciting story too, with love. There's a lot of love in it. So those two books are now coming out. Blinkdown is already there, and Citizen Karen is going to come out sometime this week, I guess, within a few days. So there's going to be more books for people to buy if they want to see my books. Some people ask me, like, you know, why don't you just get a real publisher instead of putting these things out yourself? The main reason is that it takes so long to try to find anybody in the publishing industry who's interested in your work. Could be partly because my books are terrible and they suck. But we don't have any real evidence. We don't have any anecdotal evidence for that. Most of the people that read them say, wow, this is awesome. Or some variation. And what I wanted to do always was to make sure that they're available in the event that I just drop dead one day or I get hit by a piece of space junk, that these books are things that people can get because they're a lot of fun to make, and some people think they're fun to read. And so that's why, you know, as soon as I finish one of these things and I get the artwork ready, then I just put it out there so people can get it if they want to. And I may go through my whole life being almost completely unnoticed except by a precious few people, which is okay. But it's nice to know that there's some people that appreciate what I'm doing. The other thing is that you should be writing your book, in my opinion. I think I told you this before, didn't I? You should write your life story or something. You know, write something. It's a good thing to do. It's one of the few things that I can still do. So I do it, and I enjoy it. Some people don't really enjoy writing, but let's say if you don't like writing per se, you could at least get a little recorder or talking to your phone or something and have it, you know, dictate to it and have it transform your words into a document telling your story, because it's something that everybody should do, including you, Grandma. That's all I had to say for today. That wasn't very exciting. Well, except I'm going to do laundry today. If I'm lucky, I'll be back again next Monday to bother you some more. Until then, I hope that you and all your socks will have a fine Avondvierter.